the other lesson, stone face, we have already finished yesterday. The notes will be reaching you. And now we are coming to the poem, When I Sent Out for Lambis. Understood now? So now we will go to the poem. So it is an Linus means in Arthurian legend, the mythical birthplace of Sir Tristram in England, believed to have been submerged by the sea, here at an imaginary place. So actually it is only an imaginary place. Imaginary means not in real. Understood? Not in real. Just thinking that it is there. That place, it is there already. Understood? But nobody had seen or nobody had been there. Just an imagination only. Clear to you? So now we will see what had happened to the person. I hear opposed to the poet. And when he had reached over to a particular place, that is in Linus, what had happened? Actually, it is a land which had submerged, which had come out of the out from the sea. Understood? From underneath. It had emerged up and had formed a land. That is why it is called an imaginary place. Clear to you? Now, when I set out for plans, as a young apprentice architect, who is an architect? One who designs. British poet and novelist Thomas Hardy. Who is the poet? Thomas Hardy. Once visited a parish, to parish means official, in a church, parish, official of a church, who is having a high place of a church. Yes, Christian, yes. Supervised the restoration. Restoration means responsibilities or representative, understood, of a church. So he had been sent as a representative for the supervision of the church. On his return from the park, so for a short time he had gone to England, who Thomas Hardy, as a official to supervise or represent the church. On his return from the Paris, so after that work was over, he was returning back. People noticed two things about him. A new glow in his eyes. What are the two things the people have noticed in that poet? Two things I have noticed in the poet. One is a new glow. Glow means brightness, shining. Glow in his eyes. That means a special brightness which can be seen in his eyes. And next one, second one is a crumbled piece of paper. Crumbled piece of paper sticking out of his pocket. Sticking out of his coat pocket. These are the two things people had a coat pocket. That means if you keep a paper in the pocket, the little bit of the paper is seen outside. So that is what second thing people have noticed in the poet. That means first one is a new shine, a brightness in his eye, that a new glow in his eyes, and second, a piece of a crumbled piece of paper sticking out of his pocket. So the whole paper is not being inside. Half little bit of that is seen outside, sticking outside. Clear? These two things people have noticed in the poet after he had returned from that parish work. He had gone there as a representative. That paper, it is considered to be one of the biographies contained the draft of a poem. So this paper contains this. Actually, this was the biography of a poem. Yes. Now going into read about that poem. Now, the what is being written in that piece of paper? That is a poem. What is being said in this poem? Understood? So now we will see what is the poem written in that piece of paper, which was all the time sticking out of his coat pocket. When I set out for Linus, 100 miles away. So it is not a very near place. It is about 100 miles far away. The rain was on the spray, and starlight lit my loneliness. So he had reached to a place where it seems to be lonely, and also at the same time it was very cold also. The cold represent the rain. Rain was on the spray means gracefully. It was very graceful to see the frost. The whole place being covered in the white color. That means frost everywhere seems to be. So the actually the season can be winter, isn't it? So frozen everywhere we can see the frost. And because of that, it was very cold. The place was bitter cold. And starlight lit my loneliness. And the only light he could see was the starlight. So it was the evening time. Late evening he had reached that place. When I set out for Linus, 100 miles. So when the starting of this time, when he had started his journey to Linus. Linus is the imaginary place where we had said, isn't it? So after going and doing the work of in the parish, he was returning back. By the time he had reached Linus, at the time of starlight, that means at the late evening, that means starting evening had started and the stars came twinkling on the sky. So in that brightness, that was only light he could see. Understood now? At the same time, the place also was very cold because everywhere he could find a frost. When I set out for Linus, 100 miles away, the rain was on the spray. Spray means it was graceful to see how much graceful means beauty, the beauty of that frost covered area, covered land. And starlight lit my loneliness, and he was alone in that place. And who was there? The only companion is the starlight. When I set out for Linus, 100 miles away. What would be chance at Linus while I should sojourn there? Sojourn means to stay. Sojourn. That means to stay for a short time. To stay for a short time. So he was not going to stay there till the end of his life. He said only for just a few days. And that means after coming from the church, he is willing to spend only few time to stay over in that Linus. Understood now? So what would be chance at Linus? So what is going to happen? What is the chance over there to be in Linus while I should join there? That means when I am staying there for a short time, what all things I can do within that short period? No prophet does to declare. That means I did not think about that. I did not plan about it. How I can spend over there. Especially we had already seen that in the first passage he said the place is very cold. Nor did the wisest wizard does. That means imagination. No imagination about the days how I am going to spend. What would have been answered Linus while I should join? So if I stay there, what is the most important thing that I should do it or I should see over Linus? So what is the most important thing that I have to do if I stay there for a long short time in Linus? What would be answered Linus while I should join there? So if I stay there for a short time, what will be I doing over there? No prophet has declared. That means nobody can say what I am thinking about to do in darkness. Nor did the wisest wizard guess. Even nobody can guess. Even the wise, the most wise people also cannot guess what is the thing, what is the chance, why is the chance made use of staying in lioness. What would be chance as lioness? Why does you join this? So I myself don't know. What I am going to plan over there if I stay there for a short period. When I returned, so he had been staying there for some time and he himself don't know what changes had come over him, isn't it? But he was staying there for a short period. When I returned from Lyana, so now it is time to come back. With magic in my eyes, with magic on my eyes means a new glow in his eyes. All marked with a mute surprise. That means mute means without any silent, without any sound. Surprise to guess. Nobody was able to guess what had happened to me after looking that roundness, that brightness in my eyes. So now, can you think that how was the point before and how what had happened to him once he had stayed there for a short period? Yes, before that, the poet was not seen. Poet doesn't seem to be happy over, isn't it? But he himself don't know what was the effect, what made him change within that short period. So every people had noticed two things when he came back from Lourdes. What were the two things? A glow on his eyes and a piece of paper jutting out of his pocket. When I returned from Lourdes, what with magic in my eyes, so they are saying that there is some magic seems to be in his eyes. That is why a special glowness is seen. All marked with the mute sunrise. He himself don't know how. So people are guessing what is the reason behind it. My radiance rare means his happiness. Yes, it is very rare. And if phantom plus means cannot be measured. So the happiness, how much, what is the happiness he had felt over there, or the feeling or the emotion that he had felt while he was in lioness, that cannot be measured. It is very difficult to measure it. When I returned from lioness with magic in my eyes, so he himself don't know what is the magic that happened to him within that short time of staying in lioness. Understood now? When I set out for lioness, I 100 miles away, there I was on the spray and the starlight reached my lonesomeness. When I set out from lioness, I 100 miles away. What would we have returns at lioness when I should sojourn there? No prophet durst declare, nor did the wisest wizard guess. What would be chance at lioness while I should sojourn there? When I returned from lioness with the magic in my eyes, all marked with the new surprise, my radiance rare and fabulous. When I returned from lioness with the magic in my eyes. So Thomas Hardy is the poet, and he himself had experienced that little change that had come after visiting lioness. He himself don't know, that means that frosted area where he had gone had totally changed him, had given a new life in him. Yes or no? Yes, it has given a new life in the poet. Isn't it? That the coldness, one reason is that the coldness, and the second reason is the loneliness. So he was alone over there and nobody was there, and the whole area was covered with the frost. And in that chill season, he had stayed there for few days. And those few days had marked a lot, had made him happiness. He himself cannot guess what was the change that had happened to him. So even the people, after his return, the people had noticed a remarkable change in him, isn't it? First change always seemed to be in bright glowing eyes. Second, a piece of paper jutting out of his coat pocket. And that paper is the poem. Is a biography written by the poet himself. It is being put in his coat where half of the paper is seen to be sticking outside. Those are the two symbols that can be noticed after coming back from Uranus. Now Uranus, in other end legend, the mythical birthplace of Sir Tristram in England, believed to have been submerged by the sea. Here an imaginary place, only just an imagination only. Actually there is no place like Uranus and nobody knows about it. Just it is the imagination of who? Imagination of the poet. Who is the poet? Thomas Hardy. Nerai means frost. The spray means leaves and branches of tree. What that means? Fully covered in frost. Frost is snow. Then dust means there. Big chance happen or chance to happen. So it can happen or may be happening. So John means stay there for a short time. Noise and glow. Radiance means glow. Glow means shine. Fathomless, so deep that the depth can be measured. Going very interior, very deep into the earth, which, but at the same time, it can be measured also, isn't it? But the happiness or the change that had come over to the poet after his visit to Uranus cannot be measured at all, isn't it? Because it is something very deeply happening. First answer, find the words that show.
Improbable.
impossible.
While I should join there, no prophet does declare, no did the
by radiant sphere and candelabras, pendulum from candles work magic in my hands. So now we this is a poem that I have already. So now just giving the answers for the other one. Now going back to the choir and the lesson, the Stone Age, the Great Stone Face. Just going through the answer that one. How was Ernest different from others in the valley? So how was he different from the other people of the valley? Yes, he was very kind and simple. And at the same time, what kind of a person was he? Wise, gentle, and kind. Then, not only that, all those white figures can be compared to the wise thoughts in his mind, isn't it? For all those can be compared to the wise thoughts of his mind. And at the same time, many people from far and wide used to come there to have a conversation with him. And at everyone, he used to give the answer in the correct way, which used to come from his deepest part heart of his their own. Understood now? That means whatever came uppermost or lay deepest in his heart or their own. So he was ready to give the answer to those who approached him with the questions. Now, why did Ernest think the poet was like the stone face? So, once who had come over there, the poet had come over there, who himself wanted to know. That means he had heard about Ernest, but he had never seen, so he wanted to know that person. So, he had come over there and informed him as a strange traveler who had come for a night shelter, isn't it? So the shelter was given to him and they both were talking together, and the poet could see what the poet could see on Ernest. Yes, the poet could see. He had never met a person like Ernest who was so wise, gentle and kind. And at the same time, Ernest also was measuring whom? Measuring the glowness of the poet, isn't it? So both are admiring each other. Yes, admiring each other. And then after seeing the poet, the Ernest himself had made a decision that for a long time he had been searching for the person similar to the great stone face, and now the prophecy is going to fulfill. With whom? With the appearance of whom? Yes, the poet. What did the poet himself say about his thoughts and poems? So, when Ernest had said, you are the only person to be equaled with the great stone face, how did the poet feel? He felt sad. He said, in his life he had many dreams, but they were not fulfilled. Only the dreams in his mind which were not able to fulfill. And compared to Ernest, he is more worthy than the verses or the words he has written in the poem, isn't it? So Ernest cannot be compared. He is much more than those verses. What made the poet prepare Ernest was a strong face, but the poet was confident, saying that the stone face resembles who? Ernest. That means from a far distance, he could see the face similar to Ernest with his white hairs, isn't it? That also can be seen as what is being covered over there, mist. When the mist had covered the whole mountain, he had resembled it or compared it to the white hairs of whom? Of Ernest. Then, now the next one. Whether these are being said by Ernest or poet, there was a gap between his life and his words. Yes, poet. His words and the power of truth as they agreed with his thoughts. Yes. His words were so soothing as a heavenly song, but only as useful as a valve dream. That means oil. That means he was having the dream which cannot, which up to then he was not able to fulfill. His thoughts are worthy. Yes. Who? Ernest. Whatever he said was true himself itself. Ernest. The poems were noble. According to Ernest, the poems written by the poet were very noble because he had given his thoughts where through those words. He lacked faith in his own self. According to the poet, what did he say? Only he was having the dream which were not even fulfilled, isn't it? That means only the thoughts which are in vain. That he had no faith in his own thoughts. Yes. His thoughts and power as they agreed with the life he lived. Ernest. That means his thoughts were splendid and he had lived according to the thoughts. Greatness lies in truth. Truth is best expressed in one's action. He was truthful, therefore he was great. According to Ernest, isn't it? It's because the poet was true in his life. That is why Ernest has said greatness lies in the truth. Who by common consent turned out to like the great stone face, Ernest? Did Ernest believe that the old prophecy had come true? No. Why did he say about it? What did he say about it? What did he say? Some wiser and better man than himself would by and by appear, isn't it? Bearing the resemblance to the king. So the boy had said he is the apt person to that the stone face, but Ernest did not agree to that. He said again, somebody is there more wiser and worthier than him, and maybe taking time to reach over there, but once upon a time that person will reach over there. So resembles to the great stone face. Now next one, meaning. Going down means setting. Yes, brightening. Now look bright and cheerful. Then spacious, big and wide. Prophecy, prediction. Marvelous, wonderful. Proclaim, declare. Cease, stop. Then shelter, safety. Gazed, stared at. Took on, challenged. Then we are going to study about the future tense. So future tense. Will or shall plus first form of the verb when it is simple. Clear. Suppose I shall come. So shall is they, then first form of the verb is come. Then they will wait. Clear? So will or shall plus the first form of the verb. Now coming to the next one, when it is in continuous form, will or shall plus be plus verb ing, adding ing form along with the verb. The same we can write, they will be waiting. So whenever it is continuous, add ing when it is continuous. When it is in the continuous form, you have to add what you have done, ing along with the verb. They will be waiting, or I shall be coming. So along with the verb, ing is being added. Understood now? Yes? I do hope I will live to see him. He will come, fear not, Ernest, the man will come. Gather gold is arriving tomorrow. People say. Blood and thunder, that is at the present future, is arriving. Thunder starts its journey back to the valley. next week, everyone proclaimed, the great man is going to spend his old age in the native town. Like in the verse, the verb in bold type are in four different forms, denoting four important ways of expressing future time. None of these can be said to be exclusively used to show future time, though each is used to refer in some action in future. Oh yeah. Which form of verb is more natural in the sentence? I am not free this evening. I will work. I am working on a project. I am not free this evening. I am working on a project. So that is the answer. I am working. Have you decided where you will go for your higher studies? Yes, I have. I am going to the area there. Don't worry about the dog. It won't hurt you. The washerman has predicted that, the weatherman has predicted that it will snow to Araniket tonight. Shivaponna can't go out this evening. Her father is coming to see her. Now next one, complete. Why are you turning on the radio? I shall listen. Then, oh, I can't buy this book. I have no money. Don't worry. I shall lend. Then I think it will rain. What shall we have for dinner? I can't decide. Make up for your mind. Alright, then we shall have. Why are you filling the kettle with water? I shall make. Alright, I shall go. Then shall get. Again shall get. Clear? So these are the ones you have already. So I will be sending the answers to you. You can go through it, complete that in your notebook, and read it for your exams.